Hey guys, welcome back to the Journey YouTube channel. Day out here again at the early morning. Now this video this morning is about purpose, you know. Everything in life has its purpose. And we're here to talk about purpose today. So with that be the whatever form you're coming at, the general purpose of life is actually evolution. And with evolution, you have different experiences will lead through your evolution, you know. And evolution is a personal experience based on the being, based on the frequency of the being, you know. So whether you're incarnated as a dog, incarnated as a cat, or incarnated as a human being, at the same place you really go, at the same purpose, the same general purpose you have. So no matter which form you exist in, which form you experience, you grow through, it's still evolution, you get what I say? So, with each form, even though the general purpose of life is evolution, you know, we all go through the processes differently, based on our form, no matter the form where you're coming at, or whatever, it's still evolution, as we say. But with evolution, as we say, come uniqueness, because every being goes through their personal experiences differently, and them deal it differently too, because as we say, we are unique beings and we're different. Well, not different, but unique. We are one and the same, but we are unique, you get what I mean? So there's a fine singularity. But as we say with the tree, and other beings, you know, other life forms, and the same evolution they might go through. Now we can see them look different. So the fruit's purpose, the tree's purpose is to bear fruit during the season. And the dog purpose maybe is to go around and, you know, be man's best friend. That's the way him go through evolution. That's a theme experiences the way him choose based on how him can manage, based on how him can handle. You get what I mean? Because everything has a spirit, everything has a soul, we actually create a soul plan before you incarnate physically. And when you actually come in the physical, you go through the veil of forgetfulness. So you don't really remember where you come from. But in all, the whole purpose for everybody are really evolution still, as we say. And everybody go through it differently based upon, you know, personal experiences, based upon your frequency, based upon your life path, your truth and all them something there. You know? So as we say, for the tree's purpose is to bear fruit during the season, provide shade and all of that. And, you know, your purpose is similar to the purpose of the tree, you know. But, you know, as we say, you go through different experiences because you have a different frequency from the tree. You know what I mean? But all in all is evolution. Now, what is your purpose, you know, as a being? How you find your purpose, you know? Because as we say, everything has its purpose. Everything come here for a specific reason. Don't feel like say, your existence is coincidence. It is not coincidence. It's for a specific reason why you're there. And you need to realize and acknowledge that. And the sooner you realize and acknowledge it, you realize your life become more peaceful. Automatically, you know, believe me. The moment you realize that you there's a purpose to your life, you actually start to look out for yourself better too. Because you realize you're not just come here by coincidence. You take better care of yourself, you have more self-awareness too. You get what I mean? Because you see yourself as something, you see yourself as a thing with a purpose. And you are a thing with a purpose, that's the truth. You feel like you come here by coincidence and you have no purpose. And the most stupid thing anybody could have told me. You just appear in the universe out of thin air, so with no purpose, no direction, no goal. Yeah man, there's a purpose to life, man, and every single thing has its purpose. You know, so what is your purpose? Now, where you find your purpose in life is, it's easy, just go with the flow. You know, you don't see nothing else. I try to go around and say, yo, what's your purpose? The purpose in our life is every single thing we ever do from birth until this day. You know? You do a lot of things. You just never realize it because maybe other people don't acknowledge the good way you do or maybe even the bad way you do. Because sometimes the bad way you do helps somebody to realize the good in themselves. You get what I mean? So there's no good and bad in the universe. There is just balance. You know? And whatever you do in this life is a purpose. Your care for your child is a purpose. Your care for your partner is a purpose, you know. You get up this morning, you give thanks. That's a part of your purpose too. So there's no big purpose where people fear run after and say, oh yes, my purpose is to become a millionaire or my purpose is to be this big. Whatever, you know, because people always put things in other context just to make it look like, say, yo, the purpose supposed to be this big thing and you have to sit down and go hard and wait on it and yeah, that. No, man. Every single thing is your work. Every single thing is your duty. Every single thing is your purpose. Every single thing we do. Because everything happens for a reason, you get to me? I say so. And you really and truly can't make nothing, because if you understand how the subconscious mind works with the conscious mind, the subconscious mind creates even the thoughts them with the conscious mind observe and even grasp. You get to me? I say, they find say, the conscious mind can't really think nothing by itself. It just is merely just an observer and a reactor to the thoughts them with the subconscious present. You see what I say? So if you understand that now, you realize that the subconscious really and truly deal with everything. Every single thing. You get to me, I say, and you really and truly can't do nothing or say nothing or even act on nothing without the subconscious first bringing it up to your vision, bring it up to your understanding or whatever. Bring it to your awareness. You can't really do nothing or act on nothing until the subconscious bring it to your awareness. So it's not coincidence why nothing at all happened. Everything that happened in our life is simply because it's supposed to happen and it's a part of your purpose. You know? So maybe if you go down the road and you get licked off a bicycle, a part of your purpose, you know, you're never dead. Maybe you can maybe guide somebody in the future and say, yo, don't ride the bicycle that type of way then, because last time I did, I dropped off and car licked me off or whatever, whatever. So it's still part of your purpose, man. We live our go through experiences based on our, you know, different circumstances and different way we grow up and all of that, where we deal with experiences, but all in all, the experiences is what we need for go through for the general purpose of life, which is evolution. You get what I say? But as I say, even though the general purpose of life is evolution, we are unique beings. From the ant to the tree, they're unique. They are fine to then go through, you know, different experiences, similar, you know, but different based upon the way them perceive the thing them or them are go through. Because life is all about perception. We literally there do the same thing. Every single being in the universe, I go through the same processes. It's just how you perceive the process and how you take it. You get what I say? You can take it as a negative thing. Because positive and negative things happen to everybody in the earth, you know, people. And I feel like say you alone happen to, you know. Everybody run up on roadblocks at times. But it's how you deal with the roadblocks. If you can take it as a yo, as a failure, or you can take it as a motivation to move forward again. You get what I say? If you just brush off your foot and move forward, or you can say, yo, fuck, I'm run up in a roadblock, yo, I give up here, man. Yeah, the easy thing is to give up. But we not always choose the easy thing, right? Because we depend on the party of spiritual, we depend on the part of light worker. You get what I say? We never choose the part of the easiest. We never choose the easiest part yet. Most black people are high dimensional beings. We never yet choose the easy part, because the hardest part, you know, I'm gonna bring it to evolution faster. I bring it through evolution faster, because the more you get the thing hard, you know, it push the consciousness to actually evolve quicker, in a quicker time space. So having an easy life sometimes is not always the best thing for people. So that was about purpose. I'm going to do a part 2 towards it, because I don't want to make the video too long. It's about purpose, but everything in our life has its purpose, and that's why I'm not really support killing off animals and them something like, because the animal have a purpose too, you know. But then sometimes, as we say, nothing happened by coincidence. If you find yourself a killer rat, the rat is probably supposed to, you know, supposed to tell him, do some form of, can cause some form of bad karma upon himself, I'll attract you for killing him. You get what I say? So just be comfortable in the facts, everything happens for a reason, man, and we're all there for a purpose, and we're not there by coincidence. You get what I say? We're there for a specific purpose, and your purpose is just living in a flow. Living in what makes you happy. Don't go against what makes you happy and feel comfortable. Don't go against what makes you feel serene. You know, don't make yourself uncomfortable, please. Nobody, no one, no man, woman, or child. Always make sure that you're good first. You know, it's not selfish to make sure that you're good first. Look out for yourself. No, when you don't look out for yourself, no, that's a foolish thing. You're an idiot, that's all. Because who go out of them ways to look out for everybody else and not themselves? The man doesn't love himself. If you can't love yourself, you can't love nobody else. And people need to realize in something. Anybody you see a self-sabotage for you, them not love themselves. And me no want nobody there around me a self-sabotage themselves to please me. No, please yourself first. At the end of the day, I go respect you and say, yo, you know, say, yeah, they have some love for themselves, so maybe they will love me too. But if you see you go around and not even have no love or care for yourself, brother, I mean, I don't care about you either, you know. I tell you the truth. Honestly, I pity you. I swear. You know, and we need to reach that place where we love ourselves so that other people can see the love we have for ourselves and the love we generate and can love with too. You know what I mean? Because love attracts love. Big up the Dren YouTube channel, one love.